Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger. Today we're going to talk about the fundamental theorem of projective geometry, which states that if you have a quadrangle over here and another quadrangle over here, then we can relate them by a series of perspectivities, otherwise known as a projectivity. So to get a sense for what those words mean, let's have a look at the simpler two-dimensional situation where we're talking only about lines and perspectivities between lines. So what does that mean? Here's a line L, and here's a line L prime. And here's a point O, which we're going to use as a center of perspectivity to coordinate points on this line with points on this line. So through O we draw lines connecting this A to this A prime, this B to this B prime, this C to this C prime, and we could continue to do that for all the points on this line L, associating them to points on L prime. So that association of points on L to points on L prime is called a perspectivity. Now let's suppose that we have another perspectivity between L prime and L double prime, given by a perspective point P, say. What does that mean? Well, it means that we draw lines through P. P is like our eye. And we're thinking of this and this line as being connected by these lines of vision from P. So this point, which we called A prime before, is connected to P and yields the point A double prime on L double prime. P prime corresponds to P double prime. C prime corresponds to C double prime. And all the points on L prime correspond to points on L double prime. So it gives a matching of points here and here. So that's another perspectivity. This one has center P. The previous one had center O. So what is a projectivity? A projectivity is a sequence of perspectivities. Possibly one, possibly two, possibly many perspectivities followed one after the other. So here we have one perspectivity followed by another perspectivity, and that gives a projectivity. And what that is an association between points on the line L and the points on the line L double prime. And it is that this point A corresponds to A double prime. This point B corresponds to B double prime. This point C corresponds to C double prime. Now, this picture, while it appears to be only in two dimensions, is actually a completely viable picture in three dimensions. So we can imagine this between lines which are not just all planar. So there could be the line L, there could be the line L prime. In order for them to be related by a perspectivity, they have to be in the same plane, because the plane through the line L and the point O will contain the point L prime. So if there's L and there's L prime, that would be one perspectivity, and then we could have L prime and say L double prime over here. So even though L and L double prime are not even in the same plane, they can still be related by a projectivity. All right, the fundamental theorem for this special case is that given any three points on a line, we can relate those three points to any three points on any other line via a projectivity. So suppose we start with this line and arbitrary points A, B, and C, and we want to get to this line with arbitrary points A double prime, B double prime, and C double prime. How do we do it? We use two perspectivities. The first one is going to go to an intermediate line, which is this one here, which I've arranged to go through this point, which I'm calling A double prime. So we're going to take that line and call this point also A prime temporarily. So we start with A prime, go through A, and choose any point on that line, call it O. That'll be the center for our first perspectivity. So we choose lines through O, through B, and through C, intersecting this temporary line in points B prime, C prime. So these three points are related to these three points by a perspectivity, centered at O. Now, these two lines are now coplanar because they go through that common point A prime. That means that if we join this B prime with the B double prime and join this C prime with this C double prime, those two lines are going to meet at some point P. And that's going to be the center of our second perspectivity. So a perspectivity centered at P is going to send this point to this one, this point to this one, and what's it going to do to A prime? Well, since there's a line through there, through A prime, that intersects both of these lines, it's going to leave A prime fixed. So it's going to send these three points to these three points. And so combining these two perspectivities, we get a projectivity from this line to this line, which sends ABC to A double prime, B double prime, and C double prime. So that's the fundamental theorem for projective geometry on a line. Now we want to jack that up to thinking about planes, and instead of having three points, having four points. So suppose that our initial quadrangle over here is PQRS, and these four points are assumed to be in a plane, which implies that PQ and RS actually intersect at some point Y. That's going to be important. We're going to use that point Y. And over here is an image quadrangle, P double prime, Q double prime, R double prime, S double prime. The order doesn't matter. And we'll assume that these two lines also intersect at a point Y double prime. We would like to see how to connect this quadrangle to this one via a projectivity. The key in the argument is to use the one-dimensional case that we've just established. We think about these three points on a line, and we think about these three points on a line, the P, Q, and Y, P double prime, Q double prime, and Y double prime. And we use the fact that we can connect these two ranges of points by a projectivity. So we know that we can, by a sequence of perspectivities, relate these three points to these three points. Now we're going to have to do that in a way that works on planes, not on lines. So we're going to project this quadrangle onto another quadrangle, and then onto another quadrangle to get these three points lined up with these three points. And then R and S are going to be R prime and sent to R prime and S prime for some other points, R prime and S prime. These points, P prime, Q prime, R prime, S prime, is going to be the image of this quadrangle under this projectivity that sends PQY to P prime, Q prime, Y prime. So this thing here is all in one plane. Now that once we've done that, then the final step is relatively easy. We just connect S prime to S double prime and R prime to R double prime to form a point O. How do we know we can do that? Well, it's because these two lines intersect at that point, and so they are actually planar. They form a plane. And that means these two lines here are lines in a plane, and so they have to intersect. Once we have this point O, we use that as the center of a perspectivity, which will send R prime to R double prime, S prime to S double prime, and it will send Q prime and P prime to themselves because these are the intersections of these two planes containing these two quadrangles. And that's the end of the argument. We have proven the fundamental theorem of projective geometry. And I'll leave you with a little challenge. Suppose you're given an arbitrary fivegon in a plane. How do you know whether that fivegon is actually the image under a projectivity of a regular fivegon? In other words, one where all the spreads and quadrants are the same. Okay, that's an interesting little problem. Next time, we are going to talk about conics, like parabolas, hyperbolas, ellipses, but from a purely projective point of view, going back to 19th century work of Steiner. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wahlberger. Thanks for listening.